Yo, YouTube, what's up? I'm Tim from the Cash Calling AC Sports Report, and the cities of Madrid are partying now as they celebrate their first ever World Cup in a hard-fought game that ended in overtime with a goal that was really a nice shot. It went off the goalie's hand in the net, but I'll give you the game summary, let you know a few of my final thoughts, especially U.S. side of the World Cup. Alright, so early I think Spain established that they were going to push the ball and they wanted to score and they wanted to score early and often. I think the Netherlands kind of wanted to just hang in the game, and that might have been their downfall in the end, because I think Spain was the offensive team in this game, Netherlands was the defensive team, shown that Spain had possession of the ball 57% of the time in this game. You know, it's hard to score when you don't get a ton of opportunities. The thing was, Spain had the possession, but the Netherlands made the best of what they had. They had a few, they actually, I think, had better shots on the goal. They had more opportunities where I really looked at it and said, you know what, that could have gone in. Especially that header, I say it's like 8 minutes or into the game, something like that. You know, so we'll skip through the regular rest of the game. 13 yellow cards, it's a record, I believe. And it was a physical game. Very good officiating, I thought, by Howard Webb, I believe the guy's name was, who officiated this one. I think he did a pretty solid job on a tough game to officiate because of all the physicality. So it's close to going to penalty kicks, which means your score. And Andreas Isnat, I'm sorry if I screwed that name up. Spain, please correct me on that one. He's 6, he scores for Spain, and basically from there, they started partying, he takes his shirt off, gets a yellow card, but who cares, you're about to win the World Cup, I'd do it too. So, Spain shuts it down basically from there, boots the ball to the other side for, I don't know, 5-6 more minutes, and Spain celebrates the winning of the World Cup. I mean, this game was in Soccer Town in Johannesburg, and it was a large crowd, but I saw a lot more Spain people there. And the stadium was partying, the people were partying, and when Spain scored, I think everyone knew it was over. I mean, no one had scored 116 minutes into the game. Chances are no one's going to score, or there's not going to be 2 goals within 5 or 6 minutes. That's just not likely. Okay, so back to the U.S. I hate to keep going to this, but a lot of people are going to say, was this a success? For the rest of the world, yeah, it was. For the U.S., I would say on the field it was, but that's not what I'm going to get to. Do the people really like soccer now? Or why don't they? I think the reason the U.S. does not like soccer is because they can't relate to the people because they don't know a ton of players. You know, the U.S. knows 2 international players, the average U.S. That'd be David Beckham and Landon Donovan. You know, a select few knows Wayne Rooney and guys like that, but not a ton of people. But I say if it's good enough for the world, the U.S. is not a problem because it's already the most popular sport and you should not be worried about what the U.S. thinks. I'm Tim for the Cash Calling AC Sports Report. Spain, congratulations on your World Cup win. Celebrate it. We'll see you back in 4 years. I'm Tim, and I'll see you whenever the next big sports event breaks. I'm out.